occasion, and we welcome you to the Class of 2019's commencement ceremony. On behalf of my fellow graduates who have worked so hard to be here tonight, we request that you help make our graduation ceremony a dignified and prestigious event for us to always remember by keeping your recognition to a respectful applause only. Every senior about to enter the auditorium wants to hear their full name announced tonight without interruption or excessive applause from the audience. In addition, everyone would like the opportunity to have a video memento of tonight's ceremony without audience members shouting, whistling, yelling, or using loud noisemakers in the background. We are just as excited and proud of our accomplishments as each of you are, and we want to celebrate our graduation with you after the ceremony. As a class, we have discussed what we want our memories of tonight's ceremony to be like, rehearsed the formal traditions of a commencement ceremony, and we respectfully request that each friend and family member in attendance tonight help keep our ceremony formal and dignified so that we may cherish it forever. On behalf of the Class of 2019, we thank you in advance for your support of our wishes and greatly appreciate cooperation by applauding only during designated times in the ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and remove your head coverings for our national anthem.
We're so gallantly streaming, and the rockets. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to tonight's 69th commencement at Fitzgerald High School. As the principal of Fitzgerald High School, I am honored to be hosting this evening's ceremony. Thank you to our senior choir students and Mr. Brooks for performing our country's national anthem. As always, you did an amazing job. On stage this evening are members of the Board of Education. Members of the board, as I introduce you, please stand to be recognized. Julia Yokel, President. Annie Cover, Vice President. Randall Meisner, Secretary. Judy Fergal, Treasurer. Lori Eastman-Dreyer, Trustee. Terry Wisniewski, Trustee. Kimberly Lee, Trustee. We are also joined on stage by our Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Lori Fournier, and tonight's keynote speaker, Mrs. Jennifer Crotty. Superintendent Fournier to the podium to address this evening's senior class.
Good evening, everyone. To the parents, guardians, family, friends, staff, Board of Education members who have joined our celebration for the class of 2019. You all look fabulous, and this is a glorious night and a privilege to honor your achievements during this commencement ceremony, an evening where we all share in the success of our seniors. To the parents and guardians of the graduates, congratulations on reaching this important milestone. Tonight, you should feel proud that your child will soon be a graduate of Fitzgerald High School. Enjoy this moment to the fullest and take time to congratulate yourself on this wonderful accomplishment. To our seniors, please make time before this evening is over to thank your parents or that adult in your life that helped you get to where you are today. They have sacrificed for you, advocated for you, been there when you needed a kind word, and encouraged you to keep going no matter how challenging the situation. To each of the 196 graduating students, you are here because you have completed the journey through high school and should feel excited and proud for achieving this accomplishment. Earning this opportunity to participate in commencement, it's a big deal. It means that you have successfully completed the required credits and the minimum community service hours required at Fitzgerald. Many of you exceeded both. It sounds so easy, but we know that high school is so much more. You had to complete daily assignments, projects, deliver presentations, work through late night study sessions, and pass quizzes and exams. You tested again, and then tested some more. You have made many friends, argued with friends, and discovered what a true friendship really is or isn't. You proved through this four-year journey that you were able to handle whatever came before you, and that helped shape your path to your achievement tonight. Many of you have been a student athlete, marched in the band, played in the orchestra, sang in the choir, stood on this stage as an actor, or debated over political topics. Some of you completed a career technical program, attended Macomb Community College, were members of a club, served on a council, organized school events, participated in an organized competition, or worked a job beyond high school. And some of you have done it all. So tonight we honor you for your successes that you have achieved while here at Fitzgerald. You are a class of resiliency. You may ask, what does that mean? I hear that all the time, that word resilient. Simply, it is the ability to recover from or adjust to a misfortune or change. Your senior year has been one of unplanned predicaments, opportunity, change, growth, and success. We learn lessons of accountability and that individuals are held accountable for their actions. You tackled challenges that came your way and worked hard to get beyond the unfortunate negativity that entered our lives. many of you understand, as do the parents, adult, and educators celebrating you tonight, that despite the differences in our world, we are all on a mission to lead happy and productive lives. Continue to find the good in every situation, and don't allow for your spirit to suffer. That, my friends, is resiliency. And each of you, as most people young do, continue to teach us adults on a daily basis how much resilience there is in human nature. This evening is your kickoff to life beyond high school, the beginning to many opportunities, dreams, jobs, lessons, curiosity, and lifelong decisions. Fitzgerald provided you with a solid base to begin this journey. As with all the graduating classes, the class of 2019 is no different in regards for making their mark at Fitzgerald. In addition to all the wonderful accomplishments that you will hear about this evening, you are the class that will forever be remembered for supporting the passing of our recent bond election. Even though you won't be here to welcome the many changes and upgrades to our schools and buildings, you understand the importance of increasing homeowner property values, allowing us to enhance student safety, upgrade technology, make interior and exterior renovations, and continue providing educational programs that remain competitive to other districts. And there is no other class in the history of Fitzgerald that receives so many Act of God days. Those are snow days. You were given 9, most for weather conditions. You, like all others, sat up and waited each night for that decision to be made and celebrated when the announcement became public that school was closed. I appreciate your spirit and the excitement you shared as a class, and you're welcome for all those days of extra sleep. Graduates, you represent a remarkable diversity of races, cultures, places of origins. We are proud of our student population and the rich traditions that come from each of you. It is the experiences that we share together that truly prepare you for success beyond high school. I wish you all the confidence to embrace new ideas and new people, a willingness to learn from mistakes, and a lifetime of learning and personal growth. I look forward to hearing or reading about what wonderful opportunities have been afforded you and your successes to years to come. Speak gently, laugh often, and be kind to others. Make yourself proud, make your family proud, and your alma mater proud. Congratulations to each of you.
Thank you, Mrs. Fournier. Tonight, I have the privilege of honoring the senior who has earned the highest academic distinction Fitzgerald High School has to offer. While you may think becoming the high school valedictorian is all about being smart and getting the top grades in your class, the grades are actually just a part of the accomplishments of this young woman. Olivia Morose was an active member of student government, serving as the senior council president. Her leadership capacity expanded into the theater department as the Actors Creating Theater co-president. When Olivia wasn't meeting her peers, you could find her on stage practicing her lines for an upcoming play or in her pharmacy class preparing for HOSA competitions. This year, she earned 3rd place at regionals and top 8 in the state. Olivia was never too busy. She was always finding ways to be involved and make changes. As a student who was passionate about celebrating diversity and her Egyptian heritage, Olivia naturally was a part of the FHS Multicultural Club and participant of the Generation of Promise program. If you are not familiar with Generation of Promise, it's an organization where students are selected from 17 local participating schools in Metro Detroit with only a cohort of 60 students. Their mission was to empower students to view their community as something more than just a neighborhood or their circle of friends. This experience has prepared Olivia to meet the challenges and opportunities of leadership in a diverse world, and we have no doubt that we have seen the last of her success. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to introduce this year's valedictorian, Olivia Morose. Of many great achievements and accolades. Congratulations.
Good evening, family, friends, teachers, students, and most of all, the graduating class of 2019. It is with the greatest honor to stand before you today as the class of 2019's valedictorian. On behalf of all the graduates, I'd like to thank you all for joining us on this memorable night. Nelson Mandela once said, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world." Education paves the way to achieving success, finding opportunity, and designing a brighter future. As an immigrant, my parents felt it important to teach me lessons like these to motivate and to inspire me. When high school came along, I chose to take rigorous classes with challenging coursework. After taking these classes, I soon came to the realization that with discipline and integrity, you can achieve anything. And that became my definition of academic success. After much trial and error, deadlines and stress, and success and failure, I think it is important to identify that academic success is needed for our future. In order to fulfill our ambitions and dreams, we must turn to our own definition of academic success and walk the pathway of determination. The graduates of the class of 2019 have displayed perseverance in academics, sports, extracurriculars, community service, and much more. I want to congratulate each of us who worked tirelessly to achieve our own successes. While attending Fitzgerald High School, our class was taught many fundamental principles that have prepared us for the future. We united as a diverse community, which taught inclusiveness and diminished our ignorance towards other cultures. At Fitzgerald, I learned the importance of having relationships with individuals you trust. We thank all our wonderful Fitzgerald staff members who never cease to make us laugh. Like when Mr. Smith uses weird sound effects such as to describe the next step in the calculus equation. They never cease to exhibit compassion as they would extend due dates on assignments for those of us that procrastinate. And they never cease to provide a shoulder to cry on, as we experienced many tragedies throughout the years. These experiences exceeded my expectations. As such, I now have the courage to try new things, question why, and lead with the utmost respect towards myself and others. I would like to conclude by saying it is with great pride to represent a group of future leaders, activists, role models, and pioneers. We are the architects of our lives, and we can design our future as we desire. And although the blueprint may be uncertain and challenging at times, remember, anything is possible with determination, passion, and people who love and support us. On that note, I'd like to thank our family, friends, teachers, and staff for assisting the class of 2019 to grow personally and to learn from life lessons. Congratulations to the class of 2019. The sky is the limit.
Thank you, Olivia, for sharing your words of wisdom. At Fitzgerald High School, we honor the tradition of the staff selecting a representative from the graduating class to address their peers. This year, we had 22 students submit anonymous speeches, and one individual was chosen. This student always has a positive attitude and has dedicated her time at Fitzgerald to service and leadership. This evening, it gives me great pleasure to welcome to the podium Ms. Kaylin Higgins as tonight's top speaker.
Good evening. Parents, grandparents, friends and relatives, and congratulations to the class of 2019. The class of 2019 is one of the toughest and most resilient classes known to Fitzgerald High School. We have pushed through dark times, hard times, and times where we may have felt as those who want to give up. But through those times, we have become a stronger and a more bonded community. I want to express my utter appreciation to the parents, teachers, and staff who have witnessed our journey and have watched us grow into who we are now. Our class motto is, we can, we will, watch us. This motto represents the commitment, the challenges, and the successful results of our hard work, which is walking across this stage and receiving our diploma as it symbolizes our success. To the parents, teachers, and staff, I want to thank you for your hard work also. You all are our backbone to success. You have supported us through the bad times and the good, and have encouraged us to excel beyond our expectations. As a fellow classmate of the graduating class, I am personally proud of the accomplishments of the class of 2019. To my fellow classmates, you have all overcome your struggles throughout your 4 years of high school. You have grown into the young men and women of the future of tomorrow. You have demonstrated true leadership within your community, and you have accomplished one of the main stepping stones of life. Let this graduation empower you and motivate you to reach past the stars. As we part from our four-year journey, I wish you all the very best on your path to success. Every student in this room has bright futures waiting on them. So class, let's prove to the world that our class motto holds true. That we can set goals, we will achieve them, and let the world watch us in our glory. Congratulations, class of 2019.
Thank you so much, Kaylin. Your memories and words have been inspiring and heartwarming. At this time, I would like to ask Rifa Radoshi to please join us on stage to introduce tonight's keynote speaker. As Rifa makes her way to the stage, I would just like to say a few words about her. She is one of the most outgoing student council representatives that we have. She's always concerned about the community, connecting with students, and we appreciate her.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is my utmost pleasure that I introduce you our next speaker, someone who inspires, empowers, and engages. She has touched the hearts of many students. Ms. Jennifer Prati has been a Fitzgerald staff member for the past 16 years. She graduated from Eastern Michigan University, where she double majored in history and political science with emphasis on secondary education. Ms. Prati earned her master's degree in American history and government from Ashland University. As an FHA staff member, she makes the students feel supported by always stating, please, Let me know how I can be helpful, and generally means it. As a role model to our class, she always shows such enthusiasm about her work, letting the students comprehend what it is like to live a life doing what you love. Passion is described as a strong and uncontrollable emotion in which we can see through her teaching, through her dedication, and through her unbelievable organization skills. When asked about her as a teacher, past and present students alike unanimously replied that the excitement she expresses to co-learn with us rather than teach us makes us feel like partners in a shared learning experience when it is so easy to feel like another sponge that can only absorb. For the class of 2019 as a whole, Ms. Claudia has been an integral part of our high school experiences, and many of us would not have been successful if it wasn't for her eagerness and dedication to teach and to positively influence each and every student that walks through her doors. With no surprise, Ms. Claudia has been chosen by the Fitzgerald staff as the Teacher of the Year for the 2016 and 2017 school year. She also has won the Macomb Community County Teacher of the Year in the same year. Senior Ashley Berger said, "I like how she is always there to talk to me, no matter what she is going through. She's really supportive. Showing undying care to each student that walks into our classroom, she has helped our class through many hardships. Whether it was a tragic event we all experienced together, or it was a personal problem, she never ceased to take the time to attentively listen and try to bring a smile to our faces again. Our class is so honored and grateful to have her, a heroine that comes when we are in need, that these words cannot explain the impact that she has had on our lives. Therefore, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I introduce you to our class speaker, Ms. Jennifer Crotty."
Who's taking bets on crying already? Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, guests, and most importantly, the class of 2019. 1 year ago, I stood in this auditorium with Ms. Van Gorder. I cried and I talked about how hard it would be to let your class go as we watched Mrs. Sonnenfeld give her speech. And little did I know that I would be standing here today to give that same speech tonight, because for years I have stated that I would not give this speech. Stage fright, totally happening right now. Your parents scare me, I still do. I am not an English teacher, so I have no idea about writing a speech. But your class has captured my heart and my emotions more than once, and so it just felt right. I was asked what my theme would be, or what my message would be, what I would send you out into the world with, what quote or advice I would give you. In struggling, I just kept coming back to a couple of main thoughts. First, show of hands, how many of you have had me in class? You know what I say, I will not waste your time teaching you things you do not need to know. Real content, real life, real application. The same applies here. Earlier today, we told you that graduation was for your parents, it was for teachers, it was for the people that worked hard to get you here. But right now, we're gonna take a moment, we're gonna push that all aside, because this moment is about for you right now, and what you have taught me. Since you were freshmen, I have lived the same successes and the same tragedies as you, even though I wasn't your teacher. When you became juniors, I taught you econ and I taught you government, but more importantly, you taught me. Some of you run your own businesses, and I learned about production. Some of you attempted to teach me sports,
I still do not understand them, but I do appreciate them much more. You all taught me that you can live without your cell phone when a fire breaks out during the ACT SAT testing. And you showed me that my heart belonged to the correct class in September and every month after, as we worked very hard to get here and heal. As your senior co-sponsor, I have loved getting to know many of you better, especially those of you I did not teach. You have been an amazing support team to me, regardless if you ever knew, and that is my second thought. Find your support team, but never forget the one that you have here. We say that Fitz is a family. Sometimes we are the family that drives you crazy. We are the family that you cannot wait to get away from. Sometimes I give you the evil mother eye, and you know that it is in your best interest. And sometimes it is a hug or a good cry that we all need. And some of us have done a lot of that this year. You will find that support here, out in the world, and the most unlikely places. My special guests tonight are important because they came from different parts of my life. Two of those special guests were students who sat where you sit now. Neek graduated in 2011, and Sadia graduated in 2017. These two ladies, along with my partner Stephen, of beautiful souls and have kept me grounded through events, regardless of how long time passes. Understand that you have no idea what impact you have on a person until much later down the road, as they never expected to be here tonight, just as like I never expected to be standing here in front of you. So this is what I leave you with. We are your support team. We will be here when you fall. We will be here when you succeed. And we will be here regardless of how long or how much time passes. Do not stop teaching others what you already know. Do not stop being brave and beautiful and rise up against all of the toxicity in this world to show everyone else the amazing souls that I have seen grow up next to me. Thank you for the memories, and congratulations, class of 2019.
Been our teacher and taught us not only about government, but more importantly about life. You have taught us that the Constitution and the Bill of Rights are not just words on paper, but ideas worth believing in and fighting for. So on behalf of the class of 2019, we present you with our own private Constitution and Bill of Rights. Our life lessons that you have given to us, the class of 2019. Next to your constitution is a class photo of all of us so that you remember us every time you see the constitution hanging up there. We, the class of 2019, officialed high school in order to form a more perfect student body, establish trust, ensure respect, provide for ambition, promote optimism, and secure the opportunities of success for ourselves and our peers. Do hereby establish this Clardy Constitution in honor of Miss Jennifer Clardy, official of high school. Miss Clardy, we're better, more perfect, and ready than ever to take on the real world because of you. We respect you, we honor you, we love you, and we'll miss you tremendously. Thank you.
Holding it up.
Thank you, Mrs. Crotty, for your inspiring words and also for the class gift. That was very thoughtful, and I know Mrs. Crotty will hang that in her room proudly. The theme in tonight's speeches have all pretty much reflected the strength of our resiliency, the power of our diversity, and the level of our perseverance. Each and every one of you has rose above and conquered your goals. Your future is bright. For all of those late night studies, 11:59 Google Classroom submissions, lack of sleep, and sacrifice of enjoyment, your reward is now here. Congratulations. This evening, you will notice students wearing light blue stoles. These students are members of the National Honor Society. This organization is a very prestigious organization that honors select students for their outstanding combination of scholarship, leadership, service, and character. Members of NHS, please rise to be recognized with a round of applause. Students at Fitzgerald are recognized as graduating with honors if he or she has maintained a B average or a 3.0 or higher for all 4 years. In the program tonight, the seniors graduating with honors are listed into three categories. Honors 3.0 to 3.49, high honors 3.5 to 3.74, and highest honors 3.75 to 4.0. Students, will you please stand when your category is called, face the audience, and receive the recognition of applause for your outstanding achievement. Students graduating with honors 3.0 to 3.49, please stand to be recognized with a round of applause. Students graduating with high honors, please stand to be recognized with a round of applause. And students graduating with highest honors, please stand to be recognized with a round of applause. Fitzgerald High School in pursuit of your dreams to further your education. At this time, we would like to recognize seniors who will be attending a four-year university in the fall and ask them to be stand and recognized with a round of applause. Heard. I would also like to remind you that this ceremony is joyous and dignified, and in order to hear everyone's name, I ask you to hold your applause until all the graduates have received their diplomas. I thank you for following these guidelines during the awarding of the diplomas, and after the very last diploma is distributed, I will return to the podium and join you in congratulating the entire class of 2019. This evening, graduates' names will be read by two of Fitzgerald's very own teachers, Mrs. Katie Campagna and Mr. Paul, ironically, is reading names, and I can't say his name, and I don't know if any of you can, so we will call him Mr. H. And the Board of Education will be awarding the graduates their diplomas. Mrs. Fournier, members of the Board of Education, the seniors gathered before you this evening have completed the requirements for graduation as specified by the State of Michigan and the Fitzgerald Board of Education. I recommend that they are awarded their high school diplomas.
Joshua T. Sinkowski.
Jan Michael Sampson, Geronimo.
Tassine Cabrera.
Kimberly Otiba Aguara Jackson.
Shermana Achter.
Rifa Tamana Rodoshi.
Salma Nessa Gopher.
Roshan Nuha Ali.
Sagida Zamia.
Nisha Tabisum Chowdhury.
Kaylee McKenzie Nolan.
Mazbin Kazmi.
Jasmine Taylor Masters.
Sebastian Boma Fomera.
Zachary Thomas Quillo.
Evan Garoski.
Carlicia Raymond Yankson.
Michael Anthony Fella.
Kristen Grace Yokel.
Logan Jordan Smith.
Janelle Rosmina Jean Baptiste.
Joanne Kenry Tehran Nance.
Rima Rani Dar.
Michael Claude Middleton.
Jahida Sultana Lima.
Cedric Ellis Croft.
Cornelius Pete Dodson.
Ariana Lene Green.
Darius Marcel Jones.
Jaheen Udin.
Trevor Isaiah Gibbs.
Billy Koo.
Diane Isho.
Amber Rose Bruglio.
Tia Chanel Seabrook.
Amy Frechette.
Danielle Lynn Lawrence.
Kiera Stokes.
Alexia Colette Sherrod.
Haley Marie Liberty.
Kaylin Higgins.
Katrina Bashar Putras.
Ayana Lene Bullock.
Ume Mia.
Danielle Cherie Jones.
Kanae Marie Alexander.
Jordan Simone Richardson.
Twanelle Pritchett.
Jaquela Denise Ashburn.
Tayshawn Shamar Larkin.
Beyonce Cecilia Sinclair Wooder.
Dominic Vincent McGinty.
Joshua E. Waltier.
Andrew Henry Shepherd.
Philip Edward Brown Nichols.
Kyle Jordan Taylor.
Asha One Kesey Johnson.
Daria Geraldine McCray.
JC Bianca Lindsay.
Ruth P.B. Yang.
Marissa Latrice Wells.
Elvi Alameen Rahman.
Dewan Raymond Jones.
Mahir Ahmed.
Courtney Marie Bulbarelli.
Asanur Rahman Tipu.
Marilyn Gazong Lee.
Jahanir Rahman.
Mohammed Sayed Ahmed.
Mohammed Saidul Haq.
Nina Elise Cunningham.
Sahirul Haq Safi.
Chloe Marie Grady.
Hafizer Ahmed Shakir.
Kader Marcel Howard.
Sakeem Shaharia Lilloy.
Umaya Teray Shaw.
Hunza Ali Prasada.
Ashley Kate Barker.
Tahir Ahmed Khan.
LaParis LaShawn Adams.
China Elizabeth Wheatley.
Donald Sterling Coleman III.
Samantha Marie Green. Yes.
Amanda Marie Hyatt.
Tamara Shania Chavez.
Juan M. Oropeza.
Arielle Marie Dixon.
Angel Lynn Sutter.
Angel!
Kayla Nicole Shayana Hester.
Caitlin Renee Parker.
Caitlin!
Tanaya Sierra Urban.
Seiko Elijah Maples.
Lucretia Charante Latoy Bigham.
Ali Alakman.
Sharisa Rachel Brown.
Sean Alakman.
Trine Armani Mahomes.
Brianna Cornisha Nicole Robinson.
Lanisha Jamira Hurst.
Elena Abernathy.
Avania Anijah Burrell.
Amari Rianne Siebert.
Kayla Patera Janae Arm.
Leanne Carmen Taylor.
Devon Wayne Jr.
Tia Renee Bennett.
Go ahead, girl!
Tyler William Wilkinson.
Jamisha Renee Walker.
Madison Nicole Wyckoff.
Amber Chanel Howard.
Yeah! Kyra Christine Smith.
Deja Rochelle Wright.
Mariah D. Johnson.
Melody Hope Gregory.
Amoria Shereen Singleton.
Matthew Thomas Gumbar.
Alvin Alonzo Anderson Jr.
Taquan Adams.
Musab Muhammad Mayub Saleh.
Aja Sheree Gardner.
Sydney Danae Greer.
Makasia Dominique Vaughn.
Dennis Anthony Dalton Jr.
Imani Clara Naomi Giles.
Mosamed Fatima Begum.
Javion Nelson.
Shajun Chowdhury.
Sabrina Alexis Chancy.
Rachel Fitzgerald.
Rima Begum.
Randy Fitzgerald.
Avroza Jahan Lena.
Camille Love Gibson.
Jordan Thomas Walton.
Kevin Dante Thomas.
Tay A. Goodally.
Rifa Tesnia.
Serena Mary Doherty.
Matila Akhtar.
Andrea Ingus.
Robert Samuel Joseph Dunlap.
Jolena Cheryl Faber.
Jalen James Cole.
Dajane Lenora Lanier.
Victor M. Quantrell.
Brandon Cornell McKinney.
Pamela Rose Corey.
Tyree Wesley Chapman.
Hunter Douglas Wilson.
Devin Maurice Wallace.
Ferdos Forche Chamra.
Madison Barker Humphrey.
Rosan Khaled Nuaz.
Now Hafisa Altahira Rahman.
Razu Ahmed.
Farida Khatun Tafadur.
Awula Awula Dawa.
Christopher Dion Keys.
James Jurgis.
William Dickerson.
LaShawn Elise Kidd.
Matthew Nesbitt.
Kendrick M. Harrison.
Brett Allen Hunt.
Zion Gantz.
Terry Michael Phillips Jr.
Kaven Tremaine Thomas Jr.
Kennedy Nicole Babish.
Diamond Monique Wardlow.
Carolyn M. Lee.
Cameron Sylvester Butler.
Colton Hammerick.
Leslie Giselle Hernandez.
Aaron Wesley Pope.
Keontae Bates.
Andrew Zachary Ashland.
Paul Montelise Fields.
Jason Nathaniel Holmes.
Cameron Terrell Martin.
Shavaro Lamont Burr.
Avante Augustus Farrell.
Brent M. Stempowski.
Angelo Sam Garrett-Watt.
Tyler Allen Hazard.
Of the cap tassel.
19, I'd like to congratulate you. This is a very important moment in your life, and this diploma will open many doors to you. At this time, you may now change your tassels.
And all that I meant something in somebody's.
Fitzgerald back in the 1950s and wrote the Blue and Gold alma mater during his tenure, which our senior class heard me sing to them today. I will now call on Kendrick Harrison, senior drum major, who will lead our graduates in the traditional singing of the Fitzgerald High School alma mater. Flowers at your convenience. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, the grand